Hi, nice to see you again. So it's another great day. So I believe God that God wants to do a new thing in your life. God wants to do a new thing in your life. So in this video that you want to listen to now, I want to tell you how prophecy works, how prophecy can come to pass. When God said something, how it works, how prophecy come to pass. The part that believers fail to understand, the part that we believers fail to understand, or the character of God that we fail to understand, is what I want you to understand and to learn through this video. Just listen and be blessed. So as we move on now, this video is going to be a great blessing for your life. It's going to bless your life, going to bless your family, going to bless where you think. It's going to move you to the next level of your life. So I want to tell you how prophecy, how prophecy come to pass, or how prophecy can be fulfilled. The way God deals with his people when it comes to prophecy. All right, so I want to take you right now to the book of Genesis chapter 18. Genesis chapter 18, I want to read now from verse 16. Genesis, just listen, you're going to be blessed in this video. So listen, Genesis chapter 18 from verse 16. Then the man rose from there and looked towards Sodom. And Abraham went with them to send them on the way. And the Lord said, shall I hide from Abraham what I am doing? Since Abraham shall surely become a great and mighty nation, and all the nations of the earth shall be blessed in him. For I have known him in order, that he may command his children and his household after him. That they keep the way of the Lord to do righteousness and justice. That the Lord may bring to Abraham what he has spoken to him. And the Lord said, because the outcry against Sodom and Gomorrah is great, and because their sin is very grave, I will go down now and see whether they have done altogether according to the outcry against it that has come to me. And if not, I will know. Then the men turned away from there and went towards Sodom. But Abraham still stood before the Lord. And Abraham came near and said, would you also destroy the righteous with the wicked? Suppose there were 50 righteous within the city, would you also destroy the place and not spare it for the 50 righteous that were in it? Far be it from you to do such a thing as this, to slay the righteous with the wicked, so that the righteous should be as the wicked. Far be it from you. Shall not the judge of all the earth do right? So the Lord said, the Lord answered Abraham. So the Lord said, if I find in Sodom 50 righteous within the city, then I will spare all the place for their sakes. Then Abraham answered and said, indeed, now, I, who am I, but dust and ashes, have taken it upon myself to speak to the Lord. Suppose there were 5 less than the 50 righteous, would you destroy all of the city for lack of 5? So he said, if I found there 45, I will not destroy it. I want to stop here. This is God and Abraham. God have intended to destroy the land of Sodom and Gomorrah because of the sin, because of the iniquity, because of the abominable thing that is happening then in the land of Sodom and Gomorrah. The same way it is happening in Nigeria. I want to connect it to, for you to understand what, just follow me. So God have intended, because of the prayer, because of the cry of the people, of the righteous people that are crying to God because of what is happening in the land of Sodom. I believe the only man in the land of Sodom then was Lot and his family and Abraham. So God is looking for a man or a woman that is righteous, that God will always, you know, speak to or reveal something to, what he wants to do. And when God said, reveal what he wants to do, I want to tell you that God can change his mind. God can change his mind. God is busy conversing with Abraham. Abraham is also conversing with God, asking God, if I find in the city of Sodom, in the land of Sodom, 50 righteous people, will you destroy the whole land? Destroy the whole righteous people? No, the 50 righteous people together with the wicked. He said, far be it from him. God said, I can't do such abominable thing like that. Because of the righteous people, because God knows that the righteous, that 50 righteous people have enough power to pray and the things happen, to change, to stand in gap and do something, and something happen. So God cannot destroy the righteous with the wicked, and God can change his mind when the righteous do the right thing. The righteous stand in gap. God can change his mind. God planned to bomb Sodom. God planned to destroy Sodom. God planned to rain hell upon Sodom. But God is looking for, is there any righteous people in the land of Sodom for him to change what he intended to do in the land of Sodom? So I want you to understand that when God gave a prophecy, when God revealed something, what he wants to do, and the righteous rise up and begin to pray and begin to do the right thing. You know, even when God intended calamity, God can, because of the prayer of the righteous, God can change his mind. Prayer changes things. But what I find out today is that Christians, especially in Nigeria, even when they hear prophecy, they fold their hands, they don't converse with God, they just fold their hand and expecting God to bring food for them, because your pastors are deceiving you, they don't tell you all these things. They expect God to give you, to bring food for you, cook the food, put it in a plate, bring it on your dining table, wash your hand, and begin to put it in your mouth to eat. What kind of a life is that? What kind of a lazy life they are teaching you? You are, as a child of God, anointed for battle. As a child of God, you are called by God to stand in gap, to decree something, to say, God, if you are the one speaking this, we are standing against every evil, and we are clearing the way for what you said to happen. Like the same way we are seeing God is speaking right now about what you want to do, that you have chosen Sowore of AAC to lead Nigeria to the next level. I am expecting the Christians to rise up in their inner man to say, God, let it happen. Anything that wants to stand, we are going to use prayer to destroy it. Because I believe that there are still righteous people in Nigeria, all over the world. You know, all Nigerian people all over the world that can gather together and say, let it be, let it happen, let it happen. And begin to converse with God and begin to war, I mean to fight against the evil that want to stop the good from happening, because they want evil, they want calamity. Even Abraham doesn't want Sodom to be destroyed. But some of you is rejoicing. You want to see Nigeria destroyed. You want to see the wicked to continue ruling in Nigeria. You want to see the atrocity to continue ruling in Nigeria. You want to see Nigeria totally destroyed. That's why when a prophecy, when a good prophecy, when God, when a true man of God hear what God said, the good thing that he want to do, that he intended not to happen in Nigeria, some of you are busy fighting against it. Instead of you to say, so be it. Let us stand and begin to pray and fight and wage war against evil, against wickedness. Because some of you like evil. Like to see calamity happening in that nation, like to see calamity happening in the people. So far you are eating well, you are dressing well, you don't want to know how the poor people are doing it. You don't want to know how they are feeding. If they all perish, let them perish. So as long as you have all the cars in your garage, you have all the money in your account, you have all the most expensive clothes and wristwatch in your wardrobe, you don't care about the poor people. You don't even. This is a man called Abraham. He had compassion and pity upon all the abominable things that the people of Sodom are committing against God. He begin to speak to God, intercede, say, God, if you find 50 righteous people, will you destroy this? Will you destroy this land? Which, if God has been God find even five, God will not destroy, because that five righteous will stand in God and begin to pray and say, no, let this land be saved, but let evil be buried. Let evil be buried, but let this land be saved. What is your cry? God can change his mind. Prayer can change God's heart, God's mind, what he intended to do. Prayer can change it. Prayer can change the what God did plan to do. God have given us a green light in the person of Sowore of AAC, what he intended, the good that he planned and intended for the people of Nigeria. But what are we doing? Some of you fold and let us see now. God has spoken, let us wait. You don't do anything, you don't even spread the news, you don't even call people and tell them, do you know about AAC? You don't even try to use anything God gives to you, if it is a phone or Instagram or using Facebook or anything, or even WhatsApp, posting it to the people, creating awareness, stand in prayer and say, God, we want our nation to be saved. We don't want Nigeria to perish. We don't want Nigeria to be a bomb. We don't want God to rain hell. Because the evil in Nigeria today is more than the evil in Sodom. The atrocity that have been committed in Nigeria is more than the atrocity that has been committed in Sodom that caused God to destroy Sodom. I am doing this because of my love for my country, for Nigeria. Because of the cry, because of the pain of the innocent people. Though I'm not living there, but it's my land. It's where we all of us come from. So we need to do everything to save our land. To save our land from sinking, from total utter destruction that we are seeing already. We are seeing happening. Some of you just fold hand, who is this man talking? You know, I have heard from God. I am 100%, I have heard from God. Sowore of AAC is the man. Is the man, the right man, that will save that nation. But we all need to stand and say, God, if you are the one, we are standing in gap. God, we don't want to see this evil to continue in Nigeria. God, we don't want to see our nation sink. If this man is going to choose, we stand. Everything we do is, Bible says, since the time of John the Baptist, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence. Only the violent people take it by force. Take it back. Take it by force. It is time for us to take it by force. Use everything within you. Let us do it. Stop saying, this is the time to test, to know whether you are a true man of God. I am not fake and I cannot be fake. Let me tell you, I'm telling what God said. He is the right man and he's the one that God has chosen. He is the one that God said to me is the right person. Not Atiku, not dead Buhari. Okay? So I know what I'm talking about. Now I want to show something again. God can change his mind to the righteous, his own righteous children. God can change his mind. If you don't know that, let me make it known to you. God can change his mind. I'm taking some way. So for you to understand, because all of you are busy going to church. You know, prophecy comes, but when prophecy comes, there is a path for God's, there's a path that is meant for God's children, true believers, to take up their own cross. There's a path for you to play for that prophecy to manifest, to come to pass. God can change his mind. We all can stand and the counsel of God will stand. When we take doubt, when we remove doubt and unbelief and the doubt and the, all these things that is that, you know, some will say, let us watch now and see. I am not trying to tell you not to watch, but there's something that the righteous have to do. We have to all join hands together and bring it to pass and say, God, we are standing by your word. We are standing by your counsel. We are standing and we are saying no to all the evil in the land of Nigeria. God, if you say so, let us do the right thing and take it from the hand of the wicked. I want to read something for you now in the book of I want to read Isaiah chapter 38. I remember I said to you that God can change his mind. God can change his mind. If God wants to do, if God intended evil for a nation, and God say, I want to bomb this nation, I want to destroy this nation, I want to eliminate this nation, and the righteous people rise up and begin to pray and begin to cry to God and begin to do the needings, do the right thing, God will look at the cry and the prayer and of his children, of the right of his righteous children, and change what he intended to do and bring good. God have planned good. God have intended good in that great country called Nigeria. But it is left for me and you to believe it and to do radical something and save that nation for utter destruction, total destruction that the enemy is busy plotting and planning. They are planning day and night. But God's train is busy sleeping. Say, let us wait now. He says, God has spoken to him. Let us wait now. They are not sleeping. They are busy day and night having meeting. All the occultic pastors because your pastors, they are all occultic. They are more deadly and dangerous than those Nigerian politicians. So they themselves knows what is coming upon them. If your pastors are truly serving God alone, all the Christians in Nigeria stand for surely no struggle. He have won immediately. If all the churches, all the pastors can tell their members the truth, tell them that we don't want evil anymore in our country, Nigeria. Don't want evil here. Just go ahead and vote for this young man called Sowore of AAC. Automatic ticket to the seat. He don't need to struggle at all. But the people that is even fighting him is even the pastors, because they know that what they are, that they are serving the devil, that they are more deadly, more dangerous than the politicians. But I have the key. I will, after this video, you will still receive another video. I will give all the supporters of AAC, I will give all of your tax on what to do. Let's move on. So I want to show you something now in the book of Isaiah chapter 38. I said to you, listen, 38 from verse 1. In those days, Hezekiah was sick and near death, and Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amos, went to him and said to him, thus says the Lord, set your house in order, for you shall die and not live. Then Hezekiah turned his face towards the wall and prayed to the Lord, and said, remember now, O Lord, I pray, how I have walked before you in truth and with a royal heart, and have done what is good in your sight. And Hezekiah wept bitterly, and the word of the Lord came to Isaiah, saying, go and tell Hezekiah, thus says the Lord, the God of David, your father, I have heard your prayer, I have seen your tears. Surely, I will add to your days 15 years. I said to you, God can change his mind. God can say something, but your action matters. What is your action when God says something? What is your action? God said to Hezekiah, through his prophet, he sent his prophet to go and tell Hezekiah, the same way he revealed to me, that Sowore of AAC is the right man that he have chosen. So he told Hezekiah, he sent Hezekiah to prepare his, put his house in order, that it's about to die. It's time for him to go to die. Hezekiah said, no, what is this? I'm beginning to cry to God. I mean to pray to God. God changed his mind toward the death that is coming to Hezekiah and turn it to life. God reversed it. God changed his mind and add 15 years to his life through the prayer, through the cry of Hezekiah. Can you understand this? God have said something about AAC, Sowore. What are you doing? What are you doing? You supposed to say, okay, we all supposed to go in prayer and cry to God and say, God, let it be. You have to claim what God said in faith and do your part. You have a part to play. Assuming Hezekiah just heard it and fold his hand and close his mouth, he would die. He would die. But he said, no, God, it's not time yet. Please. I pray to you. I pray. Oh Lord, I don't want this now. This is the man that God have said, put your house in order. God changed his mind and added another year. It's better for you to know that when prophecy come, you have something, you have your past to play. It's time for all of us to say, God, we claim this. Not only saying it from our mouth, we need action. We need action, action, action in every area. We need action. You need, if it is telephone, to call and let the person know the plan of God, the heart of God, use that telephone. If it is spreading the message to prepare everyone to know what God planned for this country, called Nigeria, anything, let everything function now. Let everything function now. Your mouth should not be closed. Begin to pray for Sowore. Pray for AAC. Pray for Nigeria. Pray for the Council of God to stand. Begin to pray. Say, we don't want evil anymore in that country. Whether it's your father is that evil, and I say that the good will not happen. Let heaven handle him now. Whether it's your pastor, whether it's your bishop, whether it's anybody, I don't want to know. We don't need to look at anybody now. All we need is our eyes must be on God. Let all of us eyes be towards heaven. Crying to God, God, do it. Do it for us. You can do all things. I don't want people that come here and be doubting and Thomas and the, you know, they come here and they are going to write some nonsense comments. I don't need such a thing here. I don't need it. If you don't have faith, go away. I am telling you, if you listen to this video, you know I'm serious. I'm not just making video because I want to make. I love that country. And the cry of the poor people have reached heaven, entered the ear of God. The blood of the innocent people being slaughtered day and night in that country, their blood, their cry have entered the ear of God. And God wants me and you to do the radical. Do the radical. Do something now. So I have given it to you. God can change his mind. And when God says something and we fail, the Christians in Nigeria are being blinded. You people don't know the word of God, or how God, how your father function, how your father operates. I can tell you that God can change his mind. Because God told me in the time of Jonathan and the Buhari, that he wants Jonathan to control in Nigeria. That Buhari is a vampire. He's a bloodsucker. But God said to me, I have heard also the cry. I've heard what the pastors are saying. I've heard what the citizens of the land is saying. They say that they want Buhari. God said, I'm giving them Buhari. Let him go and punish them. That he's coming to punish them. And all of you have seen him punishing all of you. Punishing because he can never punish me. If he come in the morning, I will deal with him. If he come in the night, I will deal with him. And you, even your pastors, all of them, if they need, I don't care. So you can see how they have been punishing truly all these years. Let us pray. Say, God, we don't want this punishment anymore. Please avert this evil. Let good come upon that nation. And the only good that I'm seeing right now, I say it again, as God has revealed to me, is Mr. Sowore of AAC. Take it back. I've said it. God bless you. Bye. Be serious now. Let's work it out.